Hello folks, Andrit here, welcome to this new video. Today we're going to do this in Garrett. Like in the previous tutorial, we're going to cast a ray, but this time we're going to make it by script. Like you can see, I'm not using the ray cast object, so this is really made by script. But before we start, you need to know what we're going to do. Going to the Garrett documentation, you can see that to cast a ray, we need to get from the world the direct space state, and only after that we can cast a ray using the method intersect ray. Now, intersect ray has different parameters. Like for the cast ray object, we have an origin, a target, we can exclude some object, we can decide the collision layer, and we can activate collision with bodies and areas. So just to remember, ray cast works only with objects that have a collision shape. Since they may be areas as well, you need to activate eventually that function there. Inside my GD script, like you can see, I have nothing except the input for the movement. Like I said, we need a variable, a ray origin, and it's going to be a vector 3. Then we need a target, and this is going to be a vector 3 as well. Then I'm going to add a function physics process delta, and inside of this I'm going to set the ray origin to get translation. This just because since my object is going to move and the ray is going to be casted from this object, I need the position of the origin updated by delta. Then I'm going to set the ray target to the ray origin, and this probably is going to be the trickiest part. I'm going to add to this value a vector 3, 0, minus 0.8 and minus 4. Like you can imagine, the y value here is going to create an angle between the origin and the target, and the z value is going to determine the length of the ray. Now we need to cast a ray. So if you remember, we need to get the direct space state, and I'm going to use a var space state equal to get world dot direct space state. Then I'm going to use a new variable called ray. This variable is going to be equal to space state dot intersect ray, and here we're going to set the origin, ray origin, then the target, ray target, and then I'm going to exclude the object from collision. So exclude self. So to check that this is working, I'm going to add an if ray. So if ray is true, it's going to print ray.position. And last but not least, I'm going to reactivate the movement lines. Now let's see if it's working. Okay, it's working, like you can see on the output. But you don't have to believe me on my word. I made another little example, and like you can see, I'm positioning another mesh to the point where the ray intersects, collides with the other object. Leave a comment, a like, subscribe, and keep making games!